Hello everyone, and welcome to this mini tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to recreate this lettering animation using Move by Linearity. Let's start by creating a new file. Go to File, New. Select the preset square, and we're going to leave the frame rate as 30 FPS. Click Confirm. We're going to import a file into our scene. So click New Scene, Import, and select the curve file provided, Lettering Animation. Click Open. In the Import panel, you will see as many artboards as the ones that are in your curve file, which in this case is just one. Click the artboard, drag and drop into the Scene Builder line, and then click Import. Double-click the scene to enter the editing timeline. As you can see, all the assets are laid out in the left panel. Everything is divided by groups and named properly. Let's start by animating the star. I'm going to zoom in onto the artboard, and I'm also going to zoom in on the timeline. We're going to create a twinkle effect on the star. To do so, move the playhead to second number one, and then rotate the star. You can use this handle to rotate the star, and if you hold shift while you do so, the rotation will lock every 45 degrees. You can see in the style panel that we've rotated the stars 180 degrees. And you can see on the timeline that we've now created some keyframes. This is our first animation. Move the playhead to second number two and rotate back the star. Remember to hold shift. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now the star will rotate forward and backward. We also want to change the size of the star, so move the playhead back to second number one, and in the style panel here, click the lock icon to have a proportion resizing and input 45. Hit return. Let's preview this little animation by clicking play. Perfect twinkling effect. We want this twinkling effect to be repeated, so move the playhead back to the last keyframe of your animation, and with your cursor, select everything by clicking and dragging. Copy all the keyframe by clicking Command C on your keyboard, and then Command V to paste them. Again, move the playhead at the end of your keyframe line, and paste again, Command V. As you can see, the animation is overflowing the time of the scene. So we have to increase the time of the scene. To do so, click Scene 1, and on the right, click the Animation tab. Here, we can change the duration of the scene. I'm going to increase it by 2 seconds, for a total of 7 seconds, to allow us more space to create more keyframes in the future. I want to add more stars to my composition. Before I do that, I'm going to click Animate button to switch to Design mode. When we are in Design mode, we can change a lot of things in our composition, and this will not affect the keyframes of our animation. Select the star and simply copy and paste it. Again, use the keyboard, Command C to copy and Command V to paste. We're going to paste it another 2 times, Command V, Command V. Let's rename the stars. It's important that every object on our timeline has a unique name. Perfect. Now let's reposition the star. I'm going to position star number 2 on another letter. And I'm going to do the same with star number 3 and star number 4. Before we continue, we also want to organize our layer panel. We want to put the star inside the group of the letter it corresponds to. For example, star 1 will go inside the first group. Star 2 will go inside the third group. And so on. Now, when we animate the group, the star will follow. We are ready to keep going with our animation. Let's focus on the letters. Switch back to animate mode and put the playhead back to zero. Select everything by clicking everything on the canvas. Now we want to move the letters up and down. To make sure that the letters move on a straight line, hold Shift while you do so. Move the playhead to second number one and move everything up holding Shift. Move the playhead to second number two and move everything down a bit. Hold Shift. We're going to repeat that another couple of times. We're going up. We're going down. Up again. And then for the last positioning, we're going to try and hit the center of our canvas. Let's preview the animation. Move the playhead back and then hit play. Now the text is moving up and down and the twinkling star are following. To make this animation more interesting, I suggest we offset the beginning of the animation for each letter. To do so, you simply move the playhead a little bit farther down and then select the animation bar corresponding to the letter, click and drag. You do the same for each letter, keeping the space between even. Now we are ready to preview this animation one last time. Click the beginning of the timeline to move your playhead and click play. This lettering animation is moving in a smooth wave and the stars are twinkling following each letter. Don't forget to export your results and share it with us. Thank you for joining me today. See you in the next tutorial.